The following video contains spoilers for JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 4, Diamond is Unbreakable, as well as the Rohan OVA.
In my last video reviewing JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Parts 1 through 4, I mentioned how Part 4 had the best characters out of the first 4 parts. While I still love all the supporting cast, from Okuyasu to Josuke, there's one character who was a complete standout and my favorite character in all of Part 4. Rohan Kishibe. A character who started out as a one-note villain quickly became one of the most developed characters out of the entire first 4 parts. Rohan is first introduced as a manga artist struggling for inspiration. He uses his stand, Heaven's Door, to turn Koichi and another character named Toshikazu Hazamada into books to read in order to get ideas for his manga. Rohan was already a big standout among the throwaway enemy stand users due to his interesting stand ability and motivation. Rohan wasn't another malevolent stand user wanting to bring harm to the heroes of Part 4. While he was still villainous, of course, his entire motivation was centered around wanting to improve his art. He goes to some extreme measures to do this, but it was a motivation I could understand. Thankfully, his first appearance wasn't his last. Rohan would become a regular character in the series, acting as both a friend to Koichi and a foil to Josuke. Surprisingly, as the series progresses, Rohan becomes central to the story. He and Koichi meet the ghost of a girl named Raimi, who informs the duo that 17 years prior, she was killed by a serial killer, later revealed to be Yoshikage Kira. Rohan then learns that Raimi was his babysitter as a toddler, and sacrificed herself to save baby Rohan from Kira. The heroes of Part 4 believe they solved the problem by defeating Chili Pepper, but it's actually Rohan who informs them that the serial killer is still on the loose. Rohan joins the team in their hunt for Kira, but is the only one with proper motivation. The others just want to catch Kira because it's the right thing to do. But for Rohan, it's personal. Kira killed his childhood friend, and Rohan will ensure that he's brought to justice. Sure, Josuke and Okuyasu become more motivated after Kira murders their friend Shigechi, but they were hunting for Kira already. Rohan was the only one who had a compelling motivation to defeat Kira from the start. I'd also say Rohan is the only member of the team who actively searches for Kira once he swaps identities. He takes pictures of any man he can find with a similar build to Kira, looking for hints that any of these men may be the killer he's after. Rohan's also the only one who independently finds out the new identity of Kira, having not been told by Hayato. For a character who started as a villain, this was far from where he started. Rohan has some of the most development out of any characters in the first 4 parts. He starts as a selfish villain who only cares about himself and his manga, but slowly opens up over the course of Diamond is Unbreakable. He becomes best friends with Koichi, and while he still hates Josuke, Rohan proves his newfound selflessness by being ready to die instead of sacrificing Josuke. Rohan's selfless act during the episode with Highway Star showed just how much he developed as a character, from a heartless villain to a not-so-heartless hero. Rohan was by far my favorite character in Diamond is Unbreakable, so I couldn't wait to watch the Rohan OVA and see how he would continue to develop. So, let's get this started. Okay. Rohan's just, doing some yoga. Cool. What the fuck is that? That's not Rohan. Turn it off. Turn it off. It's too scary. Turn it off.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer. Every night, I can feel my leg and my arm, even my fingers. The body I've lost.
So the first thing you should notice about the Rohan OVA is that the faces are whack. I don't think the animation is terrible overall, but holy shit, what the fuck is up with everyone's faces? Anyway, Rohan meets with his editor, who informs him of a neighborhood of mansions up in the mountains. Rohan's editor says that she plans on purchasing one of these mansions as a vacation home, so the two trek up the mountain to take a tour of the mansion. They're greeted by what the fuck is that? They're greeted by Dobby here, who shows them inside. They're seated in a private waiting room and given tea. It turns out Kyoka, Rohan's editor, was having her manners tested. She put her fingers through the handle of her teacup, a completely vulgar act.
Disgusting!
Making her lose the test. Some wild Silent Hill shit starts to happen as Kyoka gets a phone call saying that both her mother and fiancé are dead. Rohan uses Heaven's Door on Dobby, finding that he's not a Stan user, but in fact is working for the spirits of the mountain, who cause one to lose someone they love if they display bad manners 3 times. Because that's a thing now. Anyway, using Heaven's Door on Dobby was considered to not be good manners to the spirits, so now it's Rohan's turn to be tested, leading to the most intense corn on the cob eating scene of all time. But Rohan is one smart cookie, because he wrote in Dobby's head that he can't see the lines on the floor, making Dobby accidentally step on them. This is bad manners, you stupid fucking elf. So, this frees Rohan and Kyoko for some reason, and they go home. The end. Oh wait, they're at the diner and— What the fuck? Is that Koichi? What the fuck happened to him? And that's it, I guess. Kind of a random story with absolutely no significance to anything at all. It's a pretty boring episode. Not much happens that's exciting outside of the hilarious corn on the cob scene. Okay, on to the next episode. Once again, Rohan meets with another editor of his, and he explains that he's broke because he bought an entire mountain range! What the fuck? How does a mangaka have enough money to buy an entire mountain range? I digress. When asked by his editor why he bought 6 fucking mountains, Rohan explains that it's to research yokai, malevolent Japanese spirits. He begins to tell a story of the heiress to an incredibly wealthy miso fortune. She's hanging out with her secret boyfriend, but when they get into a fight, she accidentally pushes him over. He splits the back of his head open on a golf club and dies. The woman tries to bandage him up, but the body continues to bleed profusely without end, despite his heart no longer pumping blood. This leads to some silly shenanigans where she tries to hide the body from her fiancé. She succeeds in hiding it, but needs to constantly collect the blood that pours from the body's head. It turns out that indeed, the secret boyfriend was a yokai. When he died, the woman became stuck with him forever, constantly needing to take care of the body. This is what yokai feed on. What the fuck, Nintendo? This is a weird plot for a yokai watch game. Rohan knows this whole story because he encountered the daughter of the woman and the yokai, which means the woman had sex and was impregnated by the dead body. Just think about that. Anyway, he managed to defeat her with Heaven's Door before she could haunt him. And that's episode 2. Yeah, I went through that pretty fast, but who really cares? These two episodes are so boring. Despite a few good moments like the corn and Rohan signing autographs with droplets of coffee, these OVAs don't have much of anything to offer. I'm super bored just making this video about the OVAs, they're that bad. Rohan is my favorite character in Diamond is Unbreakable, and I was so incredibly excited to see his solo adventures, but they were a major letdown. Who are these OVAs even for? It can't be for Diamond is Unbreakable fans since the stories just don't have that heart or intrigue that the main series had. It's definitely not for Rohan fans because he doesn't really get any moments to shine and be that gay icon he truly is. Who are these for? I really just don't know. These episodes are a total slog to get through. Please, just don't watch these. You're only going to be wasting 40 minutes of your life. I could have watched the first 2 episodes of Part 5 or Neon Genesis Evangelion on Netflix, but no, I watched these. Why?